The Miss Universe organization unveils its newest crown in its 73rd pageant. The crown, dubbed Light of Infinity, was crafted by Filipino luxury brand Jewelmer and is made of 23 South Sea pearls. Its diamond and gold embellishments also resemble a sun with long rays. Jewelmer CEO Jacques Vernalet says the Light of Infinity took 2 years to make. It also received high praise from Miss Universe's president, Rol Rocha, as he dubbed the Filipino-made crown as one of the organization's best.
The Philippines' transport chief says the current setup of the EDSA busway system will stay as it is, following a proposal to implement a counterflow scheme on the bus carousel. Johnson Manaba joins us on the line for the details. Johnson?
Hi, Ron. Good afternoon. The Department of Transportation clarified today, November 14, that the current setup of EDSA busway will remain as it is. In an ambush interview at the transportation conference in Parañaque City, Transportation Chief Jaime Bautista said it needs to conduct consultations with stakeholders before coming up with a final decision whether to implement a counterflow system on bus carousel to avoid illegal entry of unauthorized vehicles. Bautista said it is just an idea that came out after the controversial and illegal use of busway by an SUV bearing protocol plate number 7. According to Bautista, the OTR Special Action and Intelligence Committee for Transportation, or SAICT, will implement stricter implementation of traffic rules on EDSA busway as the holiday season approaches. Meanwhile, the Transportation Department is hoping to conduct the groundbreaking ceremony of the Taguig City Integrated Terminal Exchange, or TCITX, by December this year. Bautista said the project was awarded to the Ayala Land Inc. by the previous administration. The OTR chief also gave an update on the ongoing construction of the Metro Transit Line 7, or MRT-7, as well as the Metro Manila Subway Project. Secretary Bautista said this aims to start the partial operation of the MRT-7 in the next 2 years. The OTR said it aims to operate the 12 MRT-7 stations from North Avenue to Lagro Station in Fairview, operational by the end of 2025. The OTR is also continuing its efforts to talk to affected households in an exclusive enclave in Quezon City to settle the right-of-way issue of the Metro Manila Subway Project. Also, the Transportation Department floated the idea of having cable cars as another mode of transportation in the country. According to Bautista, there is a study in Japan that suggests having this mode of transportation in some parts of the country. Bautista said it is seriously studying the possibility of adopting a cable car system as another alternative solution to traffic congestion in the metropolis. Secretary Bautista said he hopes to see more ambitious network of rail lines, not just in Metro Manila, but throughout the country when the Japan International Cooperation Agency, or JICA, completes the 30-year railway master plan for the Philippines. Ron.
Johnson Manabat with that update. Thanks. U.S. prosecutors ask a federal appeals court to pause their bid to revive the criminal case accusing Donald Trump of illegally handling classified documents, citing his election victory. Trump was accused of illegally holding on to classified documents after he left office in 2021. A federal judge appointed to the bench by Trump dismissed the case in July after ruling that Jack Smith was improperly appointed to the special counsel role, prompting prosecutors to appeal. Smith's prosecutors have asked to weigh in by December 2nd on how to proceed with the case. As they assess the impact of Trump's impending return to the White House, they have already secured a similar pause in another federal case, accusing Trump of attempting to overturn his 2020 election defeat.